DZRH, Elizalde.
Look at the bus, it's time to mend.
A corporate, same.
So, ang sinasabi ko na lang.
Isang mapayapang hapon, Pilipinas. Narito ang inyong balerina ng bayan, Lisa Macuja, na bumabati sa lahat ng nakikinig sa atin sa DZRH at sa lahat ng nanonood ng RHTV. Lalong-lalo na sa ating mga kasamahang alagad ng sining at kultura sa buong bansa. Isang manigong bagong taon sa inyong lahat. 2016 na. At salamat sa patuloy ninyong pagsuporta sa amin dito sa Art2art sa halos siyam na taon. Ang inyong pagtangkilik ang aming inspirasyon para maghatid sa inyo ng usapang sining at kultura sa radyo at telebisyon linggo-linggo. Kaya huwag sana kayong magsasawa na samahan kami para sa kalahating oras ng masaya at makabuluhang kwentuhan kasama ang aming mga espesyal na panauhin. Speaking of which, talaga namang napaka-espesyal ng aming pambungad na programa para sa taong ito. Kasama natin ang internationally renowned and multi-awarded Filipino designer na tinitingala sa buong mundo. Ang pangalan niya ay naging simbolo ng design excellence, professionalism, at creative innovation na nagbigay ng karangalan hindi lamang para sa Pilipinas, kundi sa buong Asya na kanyang kinakatawan. Kaya't huwag na huwag kayong aalis dahil sa aming pagbabalik, makakasama natin ang multi-awarded international design sensation na si Ginoong Kenneth Cobonpue.
Tinagurian ng Time Magazine bilang Rattan's first virtuoso, si Kenneth Cobonpue ay isinilang at lumaki sa Cebu City. Nagtapos siya ng may pinakamataas na karangalan sa kursong Industrial Design mula sa Pratt Institute sa New York noong 1987. Habang nag-aaral, naging apprentice din siya para sa isang leather and wood workshop sa Italy. Nang makapagtapos, tumungo siya sa Germany bilang scholar upang mag-aral ng furniture marketing and production at nagtrabaho din doon bago umuwi at manirahang muli sa Pilipinas. Nakilala siya sa kanyang malikhaing paggamit ng mga katutubong material na sumasailalim sa makabagong proseso ng handmade production. Ang mga obra ni Kenneth Cobonpue's brand ay naging tanyag sa buong mundo. Hindi lang para sa kanyang mga di pangkaraniwang disenyo, kundi pati na rin sa kanyang privileged clientele na kinabibilangan ng Hollywood celebrities at mga miyembro ng royalty. Ilan sa maraming gantimpalang nakamit niya ay ang 5 Japan Good Design Awards, ang grand prize sa Singapore International Design Competition, ang Design for Asia Award of Hong Kong, ang Society of Interior Design Top Pick Selection at ang French Coup de Jour Award noong 2014. Siya rin ang unang naging Asian designer na binigyan ng parangal bilang pinakaunang Designer of the Year of Maison et Objet Asia sa Singapore. Isang malaking karangalan para sa Art2art na makasama sa hapong ito ang tanyag at premyadong Filipino designer na si Kenneth Cobonpue.
Kenneth, it is truly an honor to have you in the show. Welcome to Art2art.
Thank you, Lisa.
And Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Okay, we know that aside from being based in Cebu, mm-hmm. you do a lot of traveling.
Yes.
So we truly appreciate you being with us here this afternoon. Let's start from the beginning. When did you first realize that you were interested in furniture design?
Well, I grew up in the backyard, basically my mom's house, where yes. She made furniture. Uh-huh. She made furniture for her clients. Mm-hmm. She was an interior designer, mm-hmm. and she couldn't find good furniture in Cebu then, so she made her own furniture at the back of our house.
Your mom, Betty Cobonpue.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. yes. And so my childhood was spent learning how to make things, mm-hmm. using all the materials that were around the house. So mm-hmm. I built my own toys. Mm-hmm. I built a bridge over our pond. I fell into it many times.
Oh, yes. Okay. Wait, how old were you at that time when you started to build?
I was about seven, eight. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And, so that young.
Yes. Mm. And then I started to... So
my, that was my your childhood. Lego.
Yes, that was my Lego. Yeah. Yes, exactly.
My son loved Lego at that age.
Yes. Yeah. So uh-huh. all the materials were there and I loved looking at all the craftsmen mm-hmm. building all these things with their hands. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. so it was natural then to want to take up something that involves making things. You
know, to follow in your mom's footsteps.
Yes, and to extend my childhood.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
uh-huh. Yes. Mm-hmm. And afterwards, I grew up in a Chinese family, and my mm-hmm. father wanted me to take up business. Mm. He says, because there was no money in design. Mm. You know? So mm-hmm. I took up business for mm-hmm. 2 years mm-hmm. In Manila, in UP Diliman. Mm-hmm. And I couldn't take the accounting, I couldn't take the math. Mm. And so I decided to take up industrial design, to shift to industrial design. Mm-hmm. You know? Mm-hmm. And there was an examination then, mm-hmm. and I failed the exam because I couldn't draw well enough.
Yes. Oh, I see. Yeah.
So okay. that was my beginning.
So you didn't let that stop you?
No, I didn't. No. Uh-huh. No. Uh-huh. In fact, afterwards, so I took off a year just mm-hmm. learning how to draw, how to learn the basics just to get into art school. Mm-hmm. And I decided to study in New York, mm-hmm. you know, the same school where mm-hmm. my mom graduated. Mm-hmm.
So in all this, was your mom like a mentor to you, and your father was the one who like wanted you to go into business?
Into business, yes. My mom was always a mentor.
And she was always like, inspiring you to go into the arts.
Yes, and uh-huh. she made her own unique kind of furniture then, uh-huh. which was different at that time because everybody was busy making reproductions, mm-hmm. you know, and she invented a technique of working with rattan. Mm-hmm. You know? It's an invention patent, mm-hmm. And a lot of those techniques are still being used in the industry today. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So she was the pioneer.
Yes.
For
yes,
rattan.
Yes. Uh-huh. Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I learned from her the value of being original, of being different. Mm-hmm. You know, and I saw also how, it was difficult for her because mm-hmm. She was not credited with her designs, you know.
Why is that?
When we are a manufacturing country, and mm-hmm. we're in Asia, and most companies, when they buy things from here, they label them under different names, different mm-hmm. brands, mm-hmm. and they never really reveal who the designer is, mm-hmm. you know. And so it goes under different labels abroad. And mm-hmm. I saw how my mom suffered. Mm-hmm. You know? Mm-hmm. And so when I was making my designs, I wanted to change all of that,
yeah.
you know, and finally, okay. get credit, not just for me, but yes. for all Filipino designers.
Yes. Yeah. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Okay, so you mentioned learning a lot from your mom.
Yes.
What would you consider the greatest lesson that you learned from your mom that you continue to uphold up to today?
I think it's the being original, being different, you mm-hmm. know, indulging, following your passion, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. Because it was really tough for her, and not all of her designs really sold well, mm-hmm. because every time you come up with a new design, it's always a challenge. It's always, mm-hmm. it's easier to follow and imitate the designs that are out there. You
know? Yeah.
And I saw how she spent sleepless nights yeah. working on her designs.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I helped her, trying to put together a design. Mm-hmm. We would sleep together, you know, at 3 in the morning. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And there I learned the value of hard work, originality,
yes.
of following your passion. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. And what would you consider your design breakthrough? Mm.
I think it was, I have a lot of personal breakthroughs, but I think probably the biggest break would be when the government mm-hmm. under SITEM, mm-hmm. which is under the Department of Trade and Industry, mm-hmm. formed a group called Movement 8.
Okay.
Yeah, this was mm-hmm. back in 1998, mm-hmm. yeah, under the late Ellie Pinto. She was the director for SITEM then. She mm-hmm. formed a group of 8 designers mm-hmm. who would showcase the best of the country in mm-hmm. all the various fairs abroad. It was mm-hmm. very well curated by mm-hmm. Buji Layug. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And that was my first break. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I had only about two designs then, mm-hmm. and Buji and her, they took these pieces mm-hmm. abroad, you know, for all the world to see.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And now, where do you get your inspiration for all your designs?
Yeah. It comes from everywhere, you know. There's no formula for inspiration, otherwise that would make the job of designing easy.
Yeah, yeah. That's true.
You know, I get
well, what would you consider your greatest influences?
Yeah, I think it's, I go through different phases, so sometimes it's nature, mm-hmm. sometimes it's our own culture, mm-hmm. it's the materials that I work with, it's from my travels, mm-hmm. you know, and it's everywhere, you know. I've been inspired by things as mundane as like a piece of bread mm-hmm. to a woman's handbag.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. 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 Well, tell us about your years abroad. What did that bring to you?
Yeah. So I studied in New York. Mm-hmm. And then I went to study again in Italy and in Germany. Mm-hmm. You know? And so in New York, I learned, well, because it's a mix. It's a jungle. You know, it's a mix of everything. Mm-hmm. And I went to a very good school that taught me the essence of a form, you know, of how we react to form, how we can manipulate it to bring out emotions in all of us. You know? Mm-hmm. And then I lived in Europe, mm-hmm. and there I really loved modern design. Mm-hmm. You know, I saw how people wanted, because all these classical things, all the classicism was all around them, so people wanted simpler things in their homes, you know. Mm-hmm. More modern, you know. Mm-hmm. Whereas in the United States, where they don't have as rich a history as Europe, mm-hmm. people wanted reproductions and classical things inside their homes. Mm-hmm. You know? So there was this was the, I learned how people live abroad, and I think that was the most important, more important than probably what I learned in school was just experience of living abroad and how the other half of the world lives.
Yeah, uh-huh. That's right. And so now you brought that knowledge to your designs when you came back.
Yes, mm-hmm. yes. And so mm-hmm. In my designs, I try to take things that are Filipino mm-hmm. and try to make it global.
Yeah.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
My goal eventually was to design something that would be inherently Filipino, mm-hmm. but that would go very well in a modern apartment in New York or in Milan. Yes.
And how do you do that? Is that does that mean you use indigenous or, you know, Filipino material for your designs?
Yes, yes. Yeah. I use either Filipino materials mm-hmm. or it's a unique way of producing something. It's mm-hmm. something that there's always something there that's different. Mm-hmm. You know? Mm-hmm. And they're trying to be always unique
in what way, like Asian or
different, just a new way of can be making something mm-hmm. or it's a new way of a form or it's a combination mm-hmm. or it's a different kind of function, you know, mm-hmm. just mm-hmm. always, because you have to be different mm-hmm. in the world nowadays, you know.
Well,
the world
to get noticed,
and the world doesn't need another chair, you know, mm-hmm. basically mm-hmm. so I always try to make it something different, and it'll always be Filipino because it's Filipino hands that made it.
Yes.
It's the craftsmanship. It's our craftsmanship that makes it possible. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of things that mm-hmm. we're really good at, especially in working with the hands. Mm-hmm. You know, that mm-hmm. can't be done replicated anywhere else in the world.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm sure you're often asked about, you know, and congratulated for all the awards and attention that you've received. But mm-hmm. let me let you recall the, I guess, the most challenging or the hardest point in your career.
I think it's getting, it's being treated seriously in the world of design. Mm. Because when I go out there, I wave the flag, the Filipino flag.
Yes.
You know?
Mm.
It's natural that people equate me with our country in terms of what we can do, mm-hmm. our whole design industry.
Mm-hmm.
And people sometimes think that because we come from a third world country mm-hmm. that it should be cheap, you mm-hmm. know, it should be of a, you know, the expectations are much lower
mm.
and I have to always exert, you know, double the effort,
yes.
you know, just to be treated on equal footing with all my Western counterparts.
That's true. Yes. So do you continue to experience this kind of stereotyping?
Yes, it's still there.
Up to today?
Yes, up to today.
Oh, wow.
Especially when we're, I'm in the luxury, trying to market a Filipino luxury brand, you know, when there's really basically none, you know, as of today. It's unheard of, right?
Okay, so, we'll get back to that after the commercial break. Marami pa po tayong pag-uusapan kasama ang ating very special guest sa ating New Year episode, internationally renowned Filipino designer, Kenneth Cobonpue. Dito pa rin sa Art2Art, magbabalik po kami pagkatapos ng ilang paalala.
Programang hatid ay sining at kulturang para sa lahat. Magbabalik ang Art2Art. Schedule ng mga inaabangang konsyerto, update sa mga magagandang panoorin sa mga tanghalan at teatro. Narito na ang Art2Art Calendar.
Narito ang ating arts calendar. Sa musika, ipalalabas ang operatic thriller ni Giacomo Puccini na Tosca sa January 12, Greenbelt 3 Cinema, Makati City. Ito ang pangatlong handog ng seryeng Metropolitan Opera in HD ng Cultural Center of the Philippines, kung saan itinatampok ang screening ng mga operatic productions ng Metropolitan Opera ng New York sa pamamagitan ng digital technology. Para sa karagdagang detalye, tumawag sa customer service hotline ng Greenbelt 3-757-7883 o sa CCP Sales and Promotions 832-3706 o mag-email sa ccpsalesandpromo@gmail.com. Sa sining visual, inihahandog ng Artquatica Artist Circle sa pakikipagtulungan ng Visual Artists of Parañaque ang Obra de Agua, isang group exhibit na nakatuon sa aquatic at marine life. Makikita ito hanggang January 8 sa Art Corridor ng Alabang Country Club, Ayala Alabang, Mundinlupa City. Kabilang sa exhibit ang mga obra nina Jandy Castillo, Chris Pizarro, Nante Carandang, Maricris Castillo, Joy Jacinto, Manuel Gamboa, Nelson Castillo, Myra Molina, Ray Velasco, Harold Gomez, JC Castillo, Michael Madiral, Chris Gomez, Raymar Conmigo, Valtz Villanueva, Ruel Santilices, Alan Escobar, Presi Brady, Maribel Galang at Randy Makalindong. Inihahandog ng Yurchenko Museum ang exhibit na pinamagatang Painted Memories, The Works of Lai Yu Son and Yue Fei Lai na makikita hanggang January 16. Tampok ang mga obra ng dalawang henerasyon ng Chinese artists, ang abang si Lai Yu Sun at ang anak na babaeng si Yue Fei Lai. Gamit ang tradisyonal at makabagong techniques, bumuo sila ng mga portraits, landscapes, animals at calligraphy. Ang exhibit ay bahagi ng Full Circle Exhibition Series ng Yurchenko Museum na nagpapakita ng mga obra ng Chinese at Sino-Filipino families. Ang Yurchenko Museum ay matatagpuan sa RCBC Plaza, Ayala Avenue, Corner Senator Hill, Puyat, Salcedo Village, Makati City. Para sa karagdagang detalye, tumawag sa 889-1234.
Usapang sining at kultura para sa lahat. Kasama ang balerina ng bayan, si Lisa Macuha. Art2Art.
Kasama pa rin natin ang ating pinagmamalaking world-class designer na si Mr. Kenneth Cobonpue. Favorite material, Kenneth, for your designs?
Yeah, I think it has to be rattan.
Rattan,
yeah, right, yeah.
Which is what your mom
used. My mom used. It's very easy to work with, very easy to assist, you know, it's easy to source. Yeah.
But isn't it hard to clean?
No, rattan is fairly easy to clean. It depends on the, you know, it depends on the design, of course.
Okay.
The finer it is, the harder it is to clean.
Yes. Okay. So, what would you say are the basic ingredients for success in the international design scene?
Oh, I think you have to be first different. Because there's just too many designs and too many designers out there, right? I think what you have should be different, and it should have a story. You know, that's unique, and it's you know, and then you have, it's like you have just to keep on telling that story, you know, until you're heard.
Could you give us a concrete example of a design that was original, different, and you know, and was heard right away.
Yeah, I think I like to think that almost all of the designs, all of my designs have that thing, especially the classics, the mm-hmm. iconic collections. Mm-hmm. They all have that that it's kind of it's different, you know. Mm-hmm. In the world, in the furniture, you would know right away if it's a Cobonpue. Mm-hmm. And that's what. That's what you want, where people know right away mm-hmm. that you know, it's like a Balenciaga bag, or you know, it's mm-hmm. the weave. There's always a characteristic that makes it a Cobonpue.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, like all original designers, I'm sure you have been imitated.
Yes.
And how do you feel about that?
Yes. I think that's I'm at the forefront. Always of intellectual property rights, mm-hmm. And that's why we really go after all these pirates. Mm-hmm. We have it's in the news. Mm-hmm. We have so I copyright and I patent my designs, mm-hmm. and we really go after them. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And, mm-hmm. you know, throw everything we can at them. And this is not only for me, but it's for everyone, for every designer who comes after me.
Yes. Of course. You're protecting your ideas.
Yes.
And which here in the Philippines is still not taken seriously.
And for us to be where we want to be, a creative capital, right, mm-hmm. of Asia and of the world, mm-hmm. we want, you know, we need intellectual property protection is very, very important mm-hmm. for a design industry to thrive.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Are there any like organizations that do this?
Yes. Actually, we have laws, and the government is serious about protecting
specifically for
property
furniture
rights.
Design?
Well, for everything now. Well, uh-huh. for furniture, but mainly, there's a lot of the cases are being held by multinationals, you know, because they have the money and they have the, you know. And mm-hmm. so, but there's very, very few cases that are really being pursued by Filipino companies, by original Filipino design mm-hmm. designers. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so, my cases are kind of the very few, and mm-hmm. probably one of the first in the country.
Mm-hmm. I see. Well, it's 2016. Mm-hmm. What are your current projects? Any current major productions that we can await from
you? Well, we're working on the airport in Cebu, the Cebu International Airport. Mm-hmm. I'm doing that with designers Bujilayog and architect Royal Pineda.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
We weren't too successful with Naia, so we're doing that now. So we're transforming Cebu.
Uh-huh, uh-huh,
yeah,
uh-huh.
And hopefully that'll be the best airport in the country. I'm working a lot of projects. Mm-hmm. Working on a bamboo bicycle.
Yes, we heard that you are working on certain green projects.
Yes.
Can you tell us about that?
Yes, so I'm working on a bamboo bicycle together with Bambike and trying to design a different kind of typology, different way of building bicycles.
Okay.
Yeah. Uh-huh. I'm working on a lot of installations around the world, mm-hmm. a lot of design projects.
Mm-hmm. So where to next? Where are you off to next?
I never know. You know, I mean, even APEC fell on my laps. And if you had asked me this question last year, I wouldn't even think that I'd be doing APEC. Uh-huh. You know, but this is a big project this
mm-hmm.
year,
mm-hmm.
and so you never know.
Uh-huh. Well, you know, artists like you who are very passionate about your work, often you are categorized as workaholics mm-hmm. and perfectionists.
Yeah.
Do you fall under that category?
Yes. Uh-huh. I'm a perfectionist.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Although I've learned to let loose over the years. But yes, uh-huh. I'm a perfectionist.
Okay.
I expect the same from all the people who work with me.
Mm-hmm. So can you tell us more about the other side, not the designer side, but not the artist side, but you know, how do you unwind?
Oh, I love vintage and classic cars.
Mm.
Yes, so I go mm-hmm. with a group of friends.
Mm-hmm.
We hold an annual tour around for 3 days around the country.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Tour de Cebu. Mm-hmm. We started that with a mm-hmm. group of friends, and we, you know, I love just tinkering with with cars. Uh-huh. You know, yeah.
Do you have a older, collection?
Yes, I have a collection. Mm-hmm. And I love the older cars because they're very simple. They're very easy to repair.
Yeah.
And they're just, you know, they're just pure. They're uh-huh. they're real in terms of form, in terms of performance. Mm-hmm. It's just, mm-hmm. yeah, something I love.
Okay. and of course, I always ask this of all my guests. What advice would you give to young designers or young artists out there who want to, you know, achieve the same success?
Yeah, I think that in everything you do, you have to of course, you have to love what you're doing. You know, you have to have the passion for it, you mm-hmm. know? And then you have to be good at it, whatever you love, whatever you're passionate in. You know?
Mm-hmm.
And third is you have to make sure that whatever you do, the world is willing to pay for it.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah. And where do you think the design industry in Asia mm-hmm. is moving towards in 2016? What are the trends, influences that we will see in 2016?
I think there's a lot of people. Because there's also more designers and yeah. people have become also more demanding. There's a lot of things that are custom, you know, they're called bespoke. Okay, it's happening now in the fashion industry.
Mm-hmm.
It's happening too in design where people want things more individual, more mm-hmm. tailored towards their needs. You know, mm-hmm. I think people are tired of mass production. You know, China's been responsible for that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I think in the Philippines, we're poised because we do everything by hand, so we mm-hmm. can customize things, we can do things in very small numbers,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I think that that's what people expect, you know,
yeah.
to see in Asia, mm-hmm. very unique, very different designs.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you, Kenneth, too. Thank you, too, Lisa.
Being our New Year's special, our first Art2Art episode in 2016. And yeah. of course, we wish you all the best and even more success.
And thank you. Thank you for having
me. Safe travels, okay. too. Hanggang sa susunod na linggo, samahan ninyo kami ulit dito sa Art2Art, kung saan ang usapang sining at kultura ay para sa lahat. Ito po ang inyong balerina ng bayan, Lisa Macuja, nagpupugay sa artistang Pilipino.